you like.
No, seriously, Uncle Reuben. Come and have a look over here at the stream. All I can get here is information about theatrical stars from years ago. Gives all the names and dates, and then there are a lot of numbers, like a kind of barcode next to each one.
I wonder what those numbers are for. Have you tried entering any of them yet, Benjamin?
No, I haven't yet, because I'm not sure what they're for. Have you got any idea, Uncle Reuben? After all, the so-called computer is your invention.
You're right, Benjamin, but you have to admit, it has been sitting round in this old shed for the past 30-odd years, and I can't remember all the things we tried to do on it.
Surely you must have some idea what all this leisure information is for, Uncle. There's so much of it. Were you interested in showing people?
Well, yes I was, but not as much as your Aunt Jessica. Now, she was really cool in that business. In fact, all these magazines are hers, and I wouldn't be surprised if these computer entries you're reading are her work.
Do you think we should try and enter some of these code numbers and see if anything else comes up on the screen?
Why not? Give it a go, Benjamin. You'll never know what this old machine will come up with next.
Yes, go on.
Give it a try, Benjamin. Maybe if I tried the numbers in a different sequence, something might print out.
Why didn't you try it this way, Benjamin?
You do it, Uncle Reuben. Maybe an old machine needs an old pen. So to speak.
Oh, and aren't we the funny ones? Okay, Benjamin, give us a go. Let's see if I can get anything.
Okie dokie, seat's all yours.
Maybe if I do this, and this, then this. Follow the steps from 1 to 3, sit back and enjoy all you see.
What on earth is that supposed to mean?
No idea. What about you, Benjamin?
Well, look, it's got instructions here, so if we follow them, obviously it's going to give us more information. Go on, Uncle Reuben. Yes. See what comes up next.
Stop and down one path, keep on the next door. YMA. Glad you enjoyed. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must rest. Bye.
Thank you.
away from here.
Maybe it would do it by itself.
I hope so, because I don't want to be stuck here forever, as pleasant as it may be.
Danny K is Hans Christian Andersen. Now, at least this is a name I've heard of. He was a famous comedian, wasn't he?
Yes, he was, but also had many other talents. He sang, was guest conductor for many orchestras, was a fine straight actor.
Wasn't he also the official ambassador for UNICEF? We learned about that in school last year.
Yes, he was. He was dedicated to the well-being of children around the world and loved to entertain them.
Thank you.
Amalekim, Zaramutzel, and Topol. We're topping many stars around the world to perform in this role, Tevian, this musical.
Oh, I love Fiddler on the Roof. I wish I could have been in that show, especially in the wedding scene.
Thank you.
around the same time. Look, see here, Ellen Sherman and Ron Moody.
We know about Ellen Sherman. We heard that song about summer camp. You know that one?
Yes, we do.
Thank you.
Here we go again, kids. Maybe the machine's getting tired. I know I am. Maybe it's going to take us back to 1991.
No, I'm sorry, Uncle Reuben. Looks like we just moved on a little further.
What is it this time, Benjamin?
Well, there are two names here again, so we must be in the same time period.
Who are they then?
Barbara Streisand and Bette Midler. Now, at least we've all heard of them.
Yes, of course. But then maybe that means that the machine's going to take us back closer to getting back home.
Thank you.
me. I also wouldn't mind things getting back to normal now. I think I've had enough of this. Uncle, do you think we should go and have a look around to see if somebody can help us get the machine to take us back to 1991?
I don't know, Pins, but I suppose it wouldn't hurt to have a look around. Benjamin, you stay here with the machine while the girls and I have a quick look-see.
Okay, Uncle Reuben, that sounds like a good idea.
called a new world. Do you love me? Do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
I love you.
Well?
With her daughters getting married and there's trouble in the town. You're upset. You're worn out. Go inside. Go lie down.
Golda, I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
No.
I know, but do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well?
For 25 years I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children, milked the cow. After 25 years, I talk about love right now.
Golda, the first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. Now I'm asking Golda, you love me.
Why?
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love him? For 25 years I've lived with him, fought with him, scarred with him. 25 years my bed is his. If that's not love, what is?
Present families, supporters of the school, friends. The weekend has been absolutely tremendous, and I'd like to say a very big thank you to all of you for attending here this evening. I sincerely hope that you have enjoyed our entertainment tonight. I'd like to say a very special word of thank you to all the children in the cast and to Michael in the orchestra, who have put a tremendous amount of work into getting themselves ready for this evening's performance. To get to this stage has entailed afternoon rehearsals, very often staying at school till well after 5 in the evening, Sunday mornings, Sunday afternoons, and I think they've really shown the commitment to this play, which is going to be the type of commitment that gets them ahead in their later years in life. I'd also like to say a special word of thank you to my deputy principal, Mrs. Jenkins, who has been the staff member responsible for getting everything on the go tonight, for supervising the rehearsals, for making sure that the children were always there. And I'd also like to say thank you to all the members of staff who have been very helpful and who have all contributed in some way to the performance this evening and, of course, last Wednesday and Thursday as well. To the mothers and the fathers of the school who have helped us with sound, with the makeup at the back, with the cues, making sure that the children are always there at the right time. To all of you ladies, thank you very, very much. It's most appreciated and very gratifying to have such a lovely bunch of parents that are always so ready to help us. Thank you. I know this is a thank you session, but it needs to be done. The association, under the chairmanship of Mrs. Caroline Chapman, also need a very special word of thank you this evening. They have manned the front of house for us every night that the play has been on, and this evening they've gone even a step further and they've provided an absolutely delightful supper for all that are here this evening. I'll put in a quick word about that quickly. There are plates on either sides of the tables. Please help yourselves to plates first and then just walk along the tables and help yourselves to whatever you want to eat. But thank you very much, mothers and fathers of the association, who have put in such a tremendous amount of work to make this weekend and the whole run of the production so successful. At this stage, I'd like to say a special word of thank you to our guests in the orchestra who have given of their time so unselfishly to make our production the special event that it was. And if I can, I'd like to just present each one of you with a little token of our appreciation. Our pianist, Judy King, and this very much, your help always appreciated. Our violinist, Matthew Farrant. Flute and piccolo, Soybarn Roberts. Piccolo, Heather Gummer. Percussion, Mary Ann Lovis. Thank you very much. We've made a tremendous friend at Kadimah, who has actually revolutionized our productions in one very, very important way, and that's with our lighting. If it wasn't for the efforts and the work of Peter Morgan, we would not have the fantastic lighting systems that we do have for our productions. And Peter always so unselfishly gives of his time, gives of his expertise, and he sits in his little box behind there, out of the public glare, and always does the lighting for us. Gidon, if you could come here so that Peter can come into the limelight. Appreciate, admire, and to love in very many ways, Beryl Skeen. Beryl is a musical director extraordinaire, and without her efforts and her dedication to our production, we couldn't have reached these heights. Beryl, thank you very much. And finally, I'd like to I don't have the words to express my gratitude and my absolute thankfulness to Linda Phillips for the... sometimes very difficult and strained conditions. She put all of this together. She worked with this very huge cast. And between Linda and Beryl, they've just done what I think is an absolutely outstanding job. They even conned me into being on the stage. So a very big thank you to Linda.
Thank you.